investing yourself in someone else. And the whole process of discipleship, both making disciples and becoming disciples ourselves, is really about keeping our eyes on Jesus. And that comes through walking the path with other disciples. This is why it's so important for us to be church together. This is why it's so important for us to worship together, to study the Bible together, to serve together, to encourage each other, to invite folks to taste and see what Jesus is all about. When the time came, Elisha was ready to pick up the mantle and carry on the work. Our challenge is to invest ourselves in following Jesus. Our challenge is to invest ourselves in each other and in people who are not yet Christ followers. We're supposed to love them and encourage them to join us on this journey. There's the mantle. Pick it up. Let's pray. Lord, we're so grateful for this story that comes to us from so long ago, when the mantle was passed from Elijah to Elisha. And Lord, we look forward to hearing in the weeks to come how Elisha was faithful in carrying on the work of your kingdom. But Lord, now the mantle is before each one of us. And I pray that by your grace we would take it up. And in our circles of influence, Lord, we would be salt and light. Lord, we would love our neighbors as ourselves in such a way that people would see the light of Christ shining through us. Lord, I pray that you would strengthen and encourage us to share a word where we have opportunity about this great, incredible thing that you are doing in us and desiring to do in the world. Drawing people to yourself. Lord, bless us to pick up the mantle and to follow you. We ask it all in the name of and to the glory of Christ. Amen. The night in which he gave himself up for us, Jesus gathered his disciples around the table. And he took bread, and he broke the bread, and he gave it to his disciples, saying, "This is my body, which is broken for you. Take and eat." And in the same way, after supper, he took the cup, and he gave thanks, and he blessed it, and he said, "This is my blood of the new covenant, poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Drink of this, all of you, as often as you would, in remembrance of me." And so we gather at this table, and we pray that this bread and this cup would be for us the body and blood of Christ, that we might be for the world the body of Christ, redeemed by his blood. Of Christ, the blood of Christ. I invite those who are helping to serve to come forward at this time. As they would come, I would say to you that this is not the United Methodist table. This is the table of Christ, and as such, all are invited to receive from it. All who are trusting in Christ for forgiveness of sins and desiring to lead a new life under his lordship. Invited to take a piece of bread and to hold on to it until all are served, and we will all partake of this together. If you require gluten-free elements, you'll find on the tray of the cups come around. There'll be a cup in the middle with both elements that are gluten-free, and you're welcome to take one of those.
Power is Just stand.